Greetings to everyone. Today we'll be looking at management and weakness. Everyone has his or her own weaknesses when it comes to running a business, especially when it comes to this field of engineering. So we'll be looking at some few advices when it comes to weaknesses as well as management. Remember, it is not about the vision you have or philosophy of your construction business that can let your business down. Take things into consideration and find if it, the people you hired, something else that can make your business fail. All the entrepreneurs are still fingering this. So failing is part of the journey. Keep improving and handling what is leaking. And I say keep handling and improving what is leaking. You have to consider your management skills and also you have to make sure that your experience is enough when it comes to this chain. Let me go to bankrupt. When it comes to weaknesses. Let me go to bankruptcy. Yeah, bankruptcy. Whereby the business is about to be closed. Whereby you add funds to your business, but you are not making any profit. What is the cause of this thing? The cause of bankruptcy. Hiring employees that lack knowledge and practical skills. Hiring employees that lack knowledge and practical skills. And then the second one, they're changing strategies all the time. When you see that the first strategy is not working for you, you're changing to the second one. And the second one, when you see that it does not produce any profit for you, change to the third one. So this might cause bankruptcy. Changing. All the time. Second one. Then the third one. Creating a company with a lack of knowledge and experience. To create a company, you have to have enough knowledge, and also make sure that you train yourself, you do practical works many times, multiple times, so that you can get enough experience. Then the fourth one, lack of commitment and dedication and support. Commitment The fourth one is the lack of commitment, dedication, and support. So I said, the first one, these are the first cause of bankruptcy. On your weaknesses, the hiring employees that lack knowledge and practical skills. Second one, changing strategies all the time. Third one, creating a company with a lack of knowledge and experience. Fourth one, lack of commitment, dedication, and support. So these are the few points that I have for you for this topic when it comes to weaknesses when you're considering a bankruptcy. Now we'll look at management. So how you can manage your business, how you can make sure that you don't experience this thing called bankruptcy. What to do, although there are ups and downs in life, but we'll look at management. Okay guys, when it comes to management, I look at some few points that will help you to grow and solve this thing of failing. So here you have, you need to have enough funding and experience. And one, alert employees about safety act. Employees about safety act. Did one. Make survey towards employees before hiring them to see if they can be practically engaged to your company. And this help you to see that those employees can afford your company, because you can have people who can't afford your company, who can't afford the challenges of the company, and then end up failing just because of that. So fourth one, seek support when things are tough. Fifth one, consistency on making improvement, because you can have enough funding and still fail in this journey. But you have to do it. You have to focus on consistency, on improving. On making improvement. These are the 5 points for management. also look at the equity compensation. What is equity compensation? What to do with it? What are the points that you have to look at when it comes to equity compensation? So here, these points, it's enough funding and experience. Alert employees about the safety act. Make something towards employees before hiring them. 6, support when things are tough. Consistent on making improvement. Okay, guys, when it comes to equity compensation, the cashless compensation, which symbolizes the ownership interest in the company. So, and it symbolizes the ownership interest. So when you look here for the owner to make a benefit. In order to make benefit in a company, you have to know some points. You need these things before you focus on your profit. So there must be an accounting strategy. Second one. Before you focus on those on the benefits of the company, you have to also have effective advice from taxation policy, because you have to pay tax on your company. You have to pay taxes, so you must know taxation. You must get effective advice from taxation policy, and also have to make a general planning. There must be ideas, there must be meetings where you share with your colleagues advice, ideas that can properly the company. Meetings where you share ideas. Must be meetings where you share. Actually, there must be you where you share ideas that can propel the company. And applying equity is the difficult task, the big headache, without knowing the price of stock or of the material, because we're talking about construction, but we don't know about the price of the material required to start the project. So applying, you must know this. Applying equity itself. So without applying equity, it's tough. Without knowing the price of material required to start a project. So that's why you must do what you call a general planning. This general planning helps you on the fifth point, right? Before you focus on the benefits of company, you must know these things. You must know these ideas. You must. Make an accounting strategy, effective advice from taxation policy, general planning meetings where you share ideas that can propel the company. Applying equity is tough without knowing the price of a material required. So, in order for to make the benefit of a company, you must know these ideas. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure you click the like button and subscribe. Thank you so much. See you in the next video.